We had imagined the electric current to be a flowing water in a river. You must have observed that water flows from higher elevation to lower elevation. But if you consider a lake, the base of the lake is flat, so the water stays still. This doesn't mean the water will not flow at all. It has the potential to flow, but it requires an elevation. Similarly, in electrical circuits, every charged particle has a potential to do work. This is known as electric potential. When similar charged particles are brought near, they repel each other and dissimilar charges attract each other. This is the work done by electric charges. So we define electric potential as the ability of charged particles to do work. Mathematically, electric potential is equal to work done divided by charge, which is W by Q. This is electric potential. What about potential difference? As the river flows only when there is an elevation, the current flows when there is a potential difference. The current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. The difference between the electric potential at any two points in a circuit is known as potential difference. This is also called voltage between two points. In a conductor, if the current flows from point A to point B, we consider A to be at higher potential and B to be at lower potential. If the current moves from higher potential to lower potential, it is called a potential drop, and if it flows in the other way from lower potential to higher potential, it is called potential rise. Let's take an example of 1.5 volts AA battery, which we use in clocks and TV remotes. This 1.5 volt means there will be a potential difference of 1.5 volts across the two ends of the battery so that the current can flow between these two ends. One more way to understand this 1.5 volts is, if a charge moves from a negative end of battery to the positive end, it will do 1.5 joules of work on an element like a bulb or a resistor. This is the work done per charge. We measure voltage in terms of volts or sometimes as joules per coulomb, and we denote it by letter V. We can also calculate voltage as product of current and resistance in a circuit. So summing up, in this video, you learnt about electric potential, potential difference, potential drops, potential rise, the definition of voltage and how it is measured. In the next section, we'll go through energy and power and explore more about how they are related.